and with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so forgive ourselves, the Son of God, the Son of God. Lord, have mercy. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all of us, so that unhindered by the Holy Spirit, we may pursue the freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever.
A reading from the first scroll of Kings. Elijah went to Sidon. After he arrived at the city gate, he saw a widow collecting wood for a fire. Elijah said to her, "Please give me a drink of water and some bread to eat." She answered, "I tell you the truth, and God knows. I have no bread and only a small amount of flour and a little cooking oil in a jug. I came here to find some firewood to cook the last meal for myself and my son. And then we will starve to death." Elijah said to her, "Do not worry. Go and prepare your meal like you said. But first, bake a small loaf of bread from the flour that you have. Then give it to me. Then make some for yourself and your son, because the Lord, the God of Israel, says, 'The bowl will not be empty of flour, and the jug will not be empty of oil, before the Lord sends rain.'" The woman went and did everything Elijah told her to do. And they ate food, she, himself and her son. The bowl was never empty of flour, and the jug was never empty of oil. This happened as the Lord said through Elijah. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response is, "My soul, praise the Lord." Response, "My soul, praise the Lord." The Lord is faithful forever. God is fair to oppressed people. He gives bread to the hungry. Prisoners are freed by the Lord. Response: my soul praise the Lord. The Lord helps blind people see. Those with heavy burdens are helped by God. He protects strangers, widows, and orphans. The Lord God reigns forever. Response: my soul praise the Lord. A reading from a letter to the Hebrews. Christ did not go into a sanctuary made by human hands. That sanctuary is only a copy of the real one. Christ went to heaven, and he is now with God to help us. The Jewish high priest go into the sanctuary once every year with the blood of an animal. Christ went to heaven not to offer himself many times like the Jewish high priest. If Christ had to offer himself many times, he would have to suffer many times since the beginning of the world. Christ came and he offered himself once only, and he took away all sin through the sacrifice of himself. Each person dies once, and after that, God judges the person. In the same way, Christ offered himself once to take away the sins of many people. And Christ will come again a second time, not to take away people's sins, but to save those that are waiting for him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord says, have faith and follow me. Even if it means you have to die, I will give you the crown of life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told people and said, be careful with the scribes. They like to walk around wearing long robes. They like people to show respect to them in marketplaces. They like to have the best seats in the synagogues and important seats of banquets. But they are mean and they take a lot of things from the widows. And then they show up by saying long prayers. Their punishment will be serious. Jesus sat opposite the temple treasury and watched the people putting money in the treasury. Many rich people put in a lot of money. And a poor widow came and she put in two small coins worth about a penny. Then Jesus turned to his disciples and said, I tell you the truth, this poor widow because the others gave some money and they had plenty of money left for themselves. This woman is very poor and she needed that money to live. And she gave all the money she had to the temple treasurer. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I've been reading some old children's catechisms recently. And in one catechism, the first question is this: who created you? God created you. Why? That is why St. Augustine said, "My soul is restless until it rests in you, O Lord." The two widows in today's readings loved very much. The first widow was not a Jew. She may have known some things about God and Israel and the prophets. She and her son were starving. But the prophet promised that the God of Israel would help her. So she shared the little food they had. It was like she stretched the love in her heart to help the prophet, Benaiah, to have hope in her. God did a miracle and multiplied the oil and the meal. What a strange miracle for God to do. There must be a good reason. God did many other miracles to Elijah for that morning. Well, he did other miracles. Her son died after this, sometime later. And Elijah raised him to life again. So when we think about these strange things, we begin to see that what happened to the woman and her son after they helped the prophet was a prophecy itself. It is like an artist's pencil drawing before they begin to paint. God will come to rescue the children of Adam and Eve. The only way to escape sin and death is for God to give us His grace so that we can live. And this is like the way that we're dependent completely on what God promised. The meal or the flour and the oil are like sacraments that Jesus gives us. In particular, the Eucharist is the food that God gives us on the journey into eternal life. The woman and her son were given food until the rain came. The story of the widow and her son is also a prophecy about God. wholesale managers be with faith? Knowing the faith quite like the Virgin Mary. And all the first saints and martyrs and missionaries came from the Jewish people. Jesus built the church on Peter and the apostles. And also, there is the example of the second widow in our readings today. Jesus said that that widow who gave money to the temple gave more than every others. That money was used to build the temple for people to pray to God and look after people in need, like widows. The woman stretched the love in her heart and put her whole life in God's hands. She gave everything she had, two small coins, which made up one penny. Many people have wondered about that small detail, that there were two small coins which made one penny. One person said that the two coins are like the Old and New Testament books of the Bible. Another said that the two coins are self-control and humility, which are needed for all of us. However, I prefer St. Bede's explanation of the two coins. He said that they represent the love of God and money. And that makes sense, because Jesus had only recently talked about that, when he said that the first and greatest commandment was to love God, and the second was to love your neighbor, and that there was no greater commandment than this. The two commandments of love God and neighbor are one. Just like there are two coins that make up one penny. So how will we compare with that poor widow at the end of our life when we meet God? Have we stretched the love in our hearts to love God and neighbor? Or will we be like those rich people who gave a lot of money, but didn't stretch the love in their hearts very far? Often we hold things tight, afraid to let them go. But everything in this world will prove to pass away. Still, there is an order to love, and we shouldn't try to love God without loving the people in front of us. The Father should give all the family wealth and home away if we stand in need. Though the family might share these things with those in need. I might just add something here. If we look at the example of the saints, they seem to test the limits of prudence in their love for God and their love. They love prudence too, but remember how St. John the Baptist went into the desert and ate locusts, honey. How St. Francis left his shoes and his clothes at home, and he was prudent. Remember how the children of Fatima, they used to have an altar cord that they put around their waist. And on that occasion, Our Lady did restrain them and say, do not wear that to bed in case they hurt themselves. But they were doing that for love of God and for all sinners. So maybe we need to stretch our hearts a little more, and stretch the love of our hearts a little more. The two small coins also remind me of the Virgin Mary. She carried her son, true God and true man, to present him in the temple. She also gave him to us at the marriage feast at Cana. Mary stood at the foot of his cross, offering the love of her heart with his on the cross. On the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came down on the church, Mary was praying in the midst of the disciples. So she joined the love of Jesus, who loved us by the sacrifice on the cross with the greatest gift of love. Jesus stretched the goodness of his heart to embrace everyone in every place and time. We should respond with all the love our hearts can. Mother Mary, all the saints, angels, and martyrs, pray for us. Let us declare our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into heaven. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Just like the widow who gave everything to God in the temple, let us be generous in our prayers and respond to God, who always gives us what we need.
Pope Francis, and for all our bishops and priests that serve the Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
We pray for our leaders in Australia, that they will always follow God's laws and make laws that are wise and fair. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
We pray for all the doctors and nurses who have been working very hard during the COVID pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
We pray for our deaf community and our parish community, that we always show our love for God and for the love of each other. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
We pray for people who are sick and those who care for them. Gentle God, give them your comfort and love, and help to ease their suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
During this month of November, we pray for all our brothers and sisters who have died. We especially pray for the soul of Vera Lewinsky. Give him eternal life with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Generous God, we seek the prayers of this community. We offer them in union with Jesus, your blessed Son, who lives. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through rules we have received the bread of all people. Fruit of the earth, the work of your hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be the
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have saved the vine of all people. Fruit of the vine and work of your hands, it will become our spiritual fruit.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your mighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice into your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, with faith, we pray, O Lord, on the sacrificial gifts of the year, that celebrating the mystery of the passion of your Son, we may honor him with love and devotion through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Lift them up.
Lift our hearts to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so the angels and archangels, with brothers and minions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without them we have lain. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, O Son of the Christ. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, O Son of you are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these beautiful persons, by sending down the Spirit of God, like a beautiful, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, form it, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice.
proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Anthony, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may know to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace, unity, and accordance with your will, from day and way, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but I only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thanks be to God.
One more thing is, as we're coming up to Advent, I thought I'd have an additional charity display at the back. This is for aid to the Church of England. You always find little flaws here and there in different charities, but this one is one that's impressed me over some time. They do very good work in some very difficult circumstances. For example, going into those places where people have been persecuted, rebuilding churches and so forth. I'll just give you an idea of some of the things they support. We'll be selling some Christmas cards for them as well, just to help support this charity. So, in some of these countries where they work, sometimes very dangerous places, they help with the formation of seminaries and priests. They help religious sisters have enough to eat and shelter and so forth. They give emergency assistance to Christian refugees. They distribute Bibles and religious books. They educate catechists. They help with construction or reconstruction very often of churches and church facilities. They help with transport for pastoral care. What does that mean? Well, for example, it might be a scoop or something for a priest or nun in Burma to get around to parishioners, something like that. They support the teaching